thing is always been where my heart's at, because I know there's so many outside the building that are in that place of just brokenness and lost. But I'm going to share a couple of them real quick. We were eating lunch one afternoon, a little bit later than normal, but we were up at a place called Lafayette's. It's right there in Orlando. And they were having the Citrus Bowl was going on the next day. And so they had Alabama and Michigan had their pep rally bands and all the stuff going. They were just kind of having a pre opportunity to party is what it amounted to. But what it amounted to me when I looked out the window was just hundreds of people that looked like they needed a touch. They needed an encounter with Jesus. Everybody else was sitting at the table, and I kind of jumped up and I went out to wander. I'd seen a person go by in a wheelchair, which got me excited. Sorry, that's what happens when your life becomes full of signs and wonders and miracles. You get a little anxious when you see somebody on a wheelchair or crutches, because you know that God's going to do something, because he's more than capable and he's truly faithful. So I went towards the wheelchair people. They had kind of gone a different direction, and I happened to just come across a family. There was a family of five. And their oldest son was on crutches. And so I just kind of stood there for a minute and interrupted him. And I just kind of explained to him what I do, traveling evangelist. I see a lot of people get healed. I just love to see the power of God move. I could tell they were believers. When I said that, the mom, I said, I can tell you guys are believers. And when I said that, the mom kind of almost burst into tears immediately, because there's nothing better. I mean, just be real. There's nothing better. Now I've got the Jesus hat and the Reckless Love shirt, but there's nothing better than just being recognized as a lover of the Lord. If someone comes up to you and says, I can tell you really love Jesus, just out of the blue, like that's when, you know, touchdown, we've accomplished something that day. Because that's the goal of life, is to walk with this glow, with this light of the world, this city on a hill, this Christ within me, the hope of glory on display everywhere I go. So I go up to this family and I tell them, I said, you know, I noticed that your son's on crutches. When I asked the Lord, and I told him, I said, I hear from the Lord. Lord speaks to me, which I think was a little bit of a off the grid for them, because I could tell they were Christians, but they were a little more religious sect. They kind of may or may not have believed in all the gifts. It didn't matter. So I just told him, I said, I hear from the Lord, and he speaks to me, and he said that your son, and I asked him his name. He told me his name. I said, you know, I feel like you don't even you don't need healing. Like the Lord told me, I need to break fear off of you, because you're more afraid of what might happen. You don't even have a diagnosis yet. And the kid goes, yeah, that's it. Yeah, I'm not even sure. It's just I'm in a real place of unknowing. And so I said, man, I said, I'm just going to pray real quick. Let's just break that fear off. So I lay hands on him, pray for him. And immediately he felt a release and tension in his knee. And I've had injuries before that were fear-based, where I've re-injured something. And he's a sports kid. I told him, you play sports? And he's like, yeah. I said, football. You heard it playing football. You're a wide receiver. And the kid's like, yeah. So immediately I got their attention. We started talking about some other stuff. When I laid hands and prayed for him about the fear to be broke off, now mom's fully crying. And so all of a sudden, like, the family's really drawn into the conversation that we're having. And then I told him, I said, you know what's really cool is, like, the watching that fear go, like you emerge back to being like this strong, we get restored, immediately get restored. And then I also heard from the Lord that said, what was cool is that this injury happened at like a perfect time to be recovered so we could get back in the football game. But more importantly, his mother had guaranteed this child that academic scholarship was not even a priority, because athletic scholarship was not a priority because she'd made his academics so strong. And then I looked at him, I said, you have a 4.0. I said, you're going after a Rhodes scholarship. Like, this is big time. And when I said that, like, dad gasped, mom did this, blah, blah. And he had, you know, the Lord's just speaking. He's just confirming things outside of the walls of the church, just releasing, you know, who he is and his nature. So I get done talking, and we pray as a family. We just kind of gather up. And then I looked at the dad, and I said, can I tell you something amusing? Because they were Michigan fans. And I said, can I tell you something amusing? I said, the best part about this whole thing for me is I grew up in Ohio, and I was an Ohio State Buckeye fan as a kid. And I said, so your son just got blessed, and your family just got blessed, and your child, the Lord just healed your son through a Buckeye fan. And he kind of looked at me almost like mean face for a second, and he said, well, he says, you know, they say the Lord will use the evil things for good. And we all laughed and just had a big, you know, hug about it, because it was funny, man. It was like, it was one of those.